This is story of a Canadian Indian, who in 1977, was convicted of committing the worst mass murder in the history of the state of Connecticut by killing his foster brother's family. People living in Cedar Hill Drive, Prospect, Connecticut, were awoken from their sleep in the early hours of Friday, July 22, 1977, by the smell of smoke and the crackling of fire. Looking out, they saw the house occupied by the Beaudoin family was a blazing inferno. The fire brigade were called and doused the flames with their hoses, but despite their best efforts, the house was gutted. When firefighters entered the still smoldering ruins, they found the charred remains of human corpses everywhere. They came upon 29-year-old Mrs. Cheryl Beaudoin dead on the kitchen floor, her clothes burned from her body. The bodies of three children were discovered in a bedroom to the right of the hall and two others in a bedroom to the left. Another child was dead in the master bedroom and two more in the bathroom. Investigators later noticed that Mrs. Beaudoin and several of the children had their hands tied behind their backs and the two in the bathroom had their feet bound together. All the children appeared to have head wounds. The victims, apart from Mrs. Beaudoin, were her own seven children: Frederick, 12, Sharon Lee, 10, Deborah Ann, 9, Paul, 8, Roderick, 6, Holly Lynn, 5, and Mary Lou, 4. The ninth victim was Mrs. Beaudoin's niece Jennifer Santoro, 6, who had been staying with the family. Police immediately launched the largest murder investigation in Connecticut's criminal history. Postmortems established that Mrs. Beaudoin died from head injuries and a stab wound in the chest. Paul also died from head injuries, while the others perished from a combination of head injuries and smoke inhalation. Within 24 hours, detectives had interviewed more than 100 potential witnesses, including the bereaved husband and his foster brother Lorne J. Acquin, who turned out to have been at the house playing with the Beaudoin children on the night before the fire. A witness later confirmed that a man had been seen in the area sitting in his car on the day before the murders. The police investigation now concentrated on 27-year-old Acquin, who, according to the criminal records, had a previous conviction for burglary plus an additional sentence for an attempted jailbreak. On Saturday, July 23, 1977, Acquin was detained for questioning. On the Sunday morning, he agreed to make a statement that on Friday, July 22, 1977, he went to the home of his foster brother Fred Beaudoin, who was at work at the time, and killed the latter's wife Cheryl, their seven children, and a niece of theirs. He admitted attacking his sister-in-law with a tire lever, after which he did the same to the children before spreading petrol round the house and setting it on fire. Later that day, Lorne Acquin was charged with 9 counts of murder and 1 of arson. Acquin eventually went on trial at Waterbury on Monday, July 16, 1979, after jury selection had taken more than a month. The prosecution emphasized that in his confession, Acquin said he might have sexually molested 10-year-old Sharon Beaudoin, but that the post-mortem examinations had confirmed there were signs of sexual injury in her case. On Friday, October 19, 1979, after 3 days' deliberation, the jury convicted Acquin on all 9 counts of murder and the charge of arson. He was subsequently sentenced to 25 years to life on each of the murder convictions and 20 for arson.